And welcome to the Steel and Gorilla Gaming Show. He's Steel. I'm Gorilla. Welcome to the party, pal.
Welcome to the party, pal.
What's up, baby? Another show.
What's going on? Yeah, man. Feeling good on a Friday. Enjoying life. So excited for tonight's episode, man. Holy shit. We got a doozy tonight.
This is what I have been waiting for since 2015, I think it was, 2016.
I know where you're going with
overly
this.
Excited. We got the Battlefield 2042 review. Oh, my reveal, and we're going to review it, I should say, but my God, I'm excited. I'm happy to puppy with two Peters right now. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, dude, you're not exaggerating. I am too. Wow, what a reveal. After watching it a few times, man, we were able to get a lot out of that reveal. I was kind of surprised, actually, with how much they gave us. Holy shit.
Oh man, I'm so excited. It was something that I'd been waiting for. We went and we've reviewed it, broke it down. We've got that. I'm excited for it. Plus, man, what a great day. What a great day. Your recipe, well, we'll get into that. Oh my God. Are you shitting me with that right now?
Yeah. It was good, man. How was your week though? You had a pretty crazy week, I think. You're always living that adventurous life.
Yeah, man. I mean, because if anybody's paid attention to the show, I live in bumfuck Egypt. The closest Walmart is an hour and 20 minutes. The closest Home Depot is 2 hours and 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And so, my weekend started off, obviously, I wasn't on stream on Sunday. My weekend started off, I had to go up north to Home Depot. I had to get a bunch of stuff for the man cave. And then my wife told me I needed new clothes. She said, it's not working for you right now. So I said, well, okay. So she made me buy new clothes and shoes and shit. She said, I look like a bum half the time. I'm like, that's fair. That's fair. Anyway, so we did that. I finished tearing off that 3/4 sheetrock from the damn ceiling. Got all the man cave tore out. And that was a pain in the ass. He kicked my old ass and let me know, don't do that again. And then, I started a new project. I've got a garage out on my side of my house. I'm cutting that in half.
Yep.
And I'm going to throw a gaming room up with soundproofing. Oh. And so I started doing that. Oh. I got all the lumber for that.
Jealous.
And now it's time to take everything I ripped out of the garage and take it to the dump. And I'll be working on that all weekend and probably for the next. Well, Wednesday I got all my sound panels coming. And then Thursday I got my sheetrock.
Yeah, I saw those.
Yeah,
those look dope, man. I mean, I might have to look at if I can find some cheap lumber somewhere. Holy shit.
Lumber wasn't cheap. I swear to God, I felt like I was buying a new PC. I sold
Leroy 2.0.
I sold my other kidney for the fucking lumber, and it wasn't even that much. It was ridiculous.
Holy shit.
I told him when I went to the lumber, we have a local lumber store. When I called him, I said, hey, if you're going to fuck me this bad, buy me drinks first. Maybe some dinner. Some
maybe a nice steak. Maybe a little steak and dessert. Maybe a nice little cocktail to wash it down. Maybe.
Exactly. So that was that. But what about you, man? I can ramble about my week all day long. What's been going on in Steel's world?
Yeah, nothing crazy. A lot of busy work. I had a pretty busy week at work. Got out into the field for the first time in God knows long, man. I'm a forester, but by golly, most of my work's done at a desk, but got outside the other day for a few hours, so that was good. Really reminded me of like why I like forestry. Fuck, it can get pretty depressing and shitty sometimes, but when you actually get out there and see it and work with it and talk about it, it's like, oh yeah, it's pretty fucking cool. So,
oh, that's awesome, man. Yeah, you told me about that and had a chance to get out and experience the nature of it all.
Yeah, it's totally different actually being out there instead of looking at it on a computer.
Right.
But yeah, so that was good. Really pumped for tomorrow, UFC 263, which we will be covering in today's episode. Having a couple of the boys over, gonna order some pizzas, make some ribs, have a few drinks.
Shit. Now you're talking business right there. That sounds awesome, man.
Yeah, so that'll be fun. Haven't been able to have the boys over in a fucking dog's age. So
thanks, COVID. What'd you do for me lately, COVID? That's an asshole, COVID. Right? Yeah, absolutely, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, man. So pumped for that. Another great week playing. We had a couple good nights, man. You were on fire on Wednesday.
Man, I've got that Eminem in my ear. We'll talk about that when we get to the highlights, man. I usually have music playing in my headphones, so yeah. I just go at it and I put it back in. Yeah, and I was able to be at least respectable, which is a good thing.
Dude, you were kicking ass and taking names. It was good shit.
Yeah, that was a good. I don't think I probably averaged between five and six kills a game. It was pretty awesome.
You welcome some kids to the party.
Yeah, welcome to the 40, pal. Well, why don't we get into the show, man? What do we got for the show today? Let's tell the people what we got.
Yeah, so we always like to start off with the news. Obviously, we will be going into depth about the new Battlefield. That's just a fact. We also have the new reveal trailer for Call of Duty Cold War and Warzone Season 4. That is scheduled to drop in, I think it's the 17th. So, yeah, sometime next, what does that put us, next week? Whatever it is, it's soon. And so we've got a lot to break down. We were able to ascertain quite a bit from the trailer. So we're going to dive into that. We're going to go to our friends Charlie Intel for a little more info. And then we've got something cool, and this was kind of inspired by one of our friend of the show, Maritime Mogul, mentioned in the chat last week about potentially doing a highlight segment. Mm-hmm. So we put together a little highlight pack. We're gonna call it Week in Review. Yeah, and it's just gonna be some funny videos, some good cool video, just entertaining clips. So
just the highlights of what we did.
Exactly. And then we've got something also really, we're kind of going in a different direction this week. And we're way excited. Mm-hmm. So instead of having a pre-recorded interview this week, we're actually going to have a live Warzone panel with a few of our friends are going to join us. And we're going to dive into, I guess it's not a war, it's just a gaming panel, I suppose. We're going to dive into Battlefield and we're going to dive into Warzone and just kind of shoot the shit and listen and talk about what everybody thinks about the games, about the reveal, just kind of what's going on, what guns they were using, what we're excited about with Battlefield. So it's just going to be, you know, a couple guys and a gal hanging out, shooting the shit. And we really think you guys are going to like that.
Yeah. And if I may interject, you know, one of the things that we the interviews are definitely our staple. They're exactly what we're about. We want to bring the better players on. But, you know, there comes a time when we want to introduce the people in the show, the people you see us playing with, put a face to the name and to the voice. And then this one was a little different. We decided to wait for this week. We're going to do it 2 weeks ago, and we decided to wait for this week. And the reason being for it is it's Battlefield 6, and all of us have played a Battlefield. All of us are somewhat of a fan. I wouldn't say we're all great fans. But it gives us an opportunity to have an open discussion. Instead of hearing one person's opinion, we get to hear several. And it opens up the dialogue for what, really, for me, is the most exciting. I mean, this is the most excited I've been about a game in literally since Battlefield 4. And that's the honest to God truth. And so we're way hyped about it. So we hope you enjoy it. And who the hell knows what's going to happen? It's live. Usually we do our shit. We cover that. We cut it up and we're able to mess up and do
it. We got some characters for tonight.
It's going to be funny
shit. It's going to be funny. Yeah. Get your popcorn ready. Get your drinks ready. Absolutely. It's going to be hilarious. I'm nervous, but in a good way, because who the hell knows what roads we're going to go down in.
Uncharted territories. It's a big risk for us, but what the hell? What the hell? Yeah, with John in there, it's going to be... just don't know.
Jesus.
You just
don't spoiler know. Alert, Dixie's going to be there.
yeah, so... Anyway, dude, I'm wearing this black shirt, and it's absolutely atrocious on
I was
going to
say that.
Oh,
I was going to say that.
I'm moving left, I'm moving right, and the next thing I know, it's over my face.
If you stay just like that...
Right here, good. This is where I got to be. This is my home. Like, I don't remember if you remember Hitch when he was teaching the fat guy how to dance. This is your home. This is where you stay right here. Right here. Don't move. This is your home. That's what I feel like right now. Feel like the fat guy. Kevin
shit.
James, I think his name is. Anyway.
Good.
And then what about our
stash and goods.
Yeah.
So after the panel, we're gonna kick our friends out and we're gonna jump back into Steel Stash and Gorilla's Goods. And this week, it was my turn to pick a recipe. We had the Southwest steak with corn and mash last week, which was phenomenal, to say the least. And this week, I decided we were going to try something. Whether or not you guys have heard of this, I don't know, but I had this quite a bit when I was growing up. It's called beer chicken, and it's literally jamming a half-empty can of beer up a chicken's ass.
Beautiful.
And putting it on the barbecue and letting it sit for an hour. I mean, there's a little more to it than that, but we'll get to that when the segment pops up. And after that, we're going to roll into sports. We're going to break down the latest and greatest of the NHL and the NBA playoffs. And then if we have any time, oh, whoops, how could I forget this? UFC 263. Mm-hmm. I'm going to preview it. I've got some picks I'm going to talk about. I'll be gambling on it if you want to.
And you Steel does roll good. My Steel picks. Does phenomenal with it.
I do pretty good with the UFC. I was on a five-week win streak there. I didn't play last week. I wasn't interested in the card enough, so I didn't bother.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so if you want to
follow
along. I
will say this, and I hope Killa Gorilla is watching. And Killa, if you're watching, we want your input on this shit because Killa knows so much about it. I'd love to hear his take on your picks. I'd love to. That would be be very good.
I appreciate any feedback, if especially from someone like yourself, Killa, who's who is well-versed in mixed martial arts.
Yeah.
Black belt, I believe.
He is. He's
in
jiu-jitsu? A badass. Karate. He's a badass.
Karate.
He's an Killa Gorilla is an absolute badass. I'm going to be honest with you. All right.
So you can roll with my picks or you can fade me. It's
absolutely.
All up to you.
Throw some shade on his ass, Killa. All righty. Well, let's
but that,
let's
that'll
get
be
into
about it.
It. Yeah, let's get into the news.
Mm-hmm. So I know everybody wants to hear about Battlefield. Of course, we will get to it, but we are going to start with COD news.
Yeah, let's do it. What do we got going in COD Warzone this time?
Yeah, so let's get right on up to the top, and we'll start it from there.
Awesome. Let's break it. Whoa, wrong way. Wrong way. There we go.
All good. All good.
All right.
So we've got a Season 4 start date. I believe it is June 17th. If you could scroll down just a little bit.
June 17th, right there.
Yeah, June 17th. So we're going to get a brand new battle pass, like we always do. We're going to get new guns, new multiplayer maps. We're also going to be getting a new drop location in Warzone. Yep. Let's play the trailer.
Yeah, let me turn this down a bit. All right, tell us what's about the trailer. The trailer is kind of exciting.
Mm-hmm. So you'll recognize a couple of things here if you're a Call of Duty fanboy. So you guys know the map with the satellite. This is it.
Yeah, I forget the name of it, but it was in Black Ops, in one of the Black Ops, wasn't it?
It's in Cold War.
Oh, Cold War.
This is literally the desert from Cold War.
There you go. Yeah.
Yep. And yeah, you can see there's gonna be a new 2v2 gunfight map. Hijacked is coming back. So anybody who's a Call of Duty fan, Hijacked is coming back. And Hijacked is rumored to be the new Gulag as well. This is the new drop location orbit. There you can see the satellite. Trying to figure out where exactly they're gonna put that. The new zombies. Pretty cool if you're into zombies.
There's the ghoulie. There's the ghoulie.
Yep.
And it's about, you know, not to get on a tangent, but I'm going to. It's about goddamn time. It's about the goddamn time we got a new gulag.
I hate the current gulag. I know you do as well.
Oh, man. I mean, we were talking about it. Somebody had suggested let's do a Trials and Tribulations of the gulag, and we were going to do it. And then we realized that there was a new one coming out, kind of pointless. But, I mean, that gulag was so damn big, it felt like I was playing Nuketown with two of us. It was absolute shit. One side of it was absolutely more advantageous than the other side. The side of the car, you had a big advantage than the other side on the other side of the tank.
It's interesting because we were going to talk about gulags this week, but never just didn't fit in the scheduling of all of our stuff. But I'm really excited for a new gulag.
Absolutely. Way excited. Mm-hmm. And then what about, you said that the zombies are coming out. I'm not a big zombie guy. I've never played it.
I don't play much of the zombies. Honestly, a lot of people do. Mm-hmm. Cold War has kind of turned into a zombie exclusive game. Like most people who are still playing it only really play it for zombies. There are some of the odd hardcores that play the multiplayer, but it's mostly the zombies. One thing that's interesting, and since you've got it right here on the screen, is these are a couple of the new rumored guns that are going to drop on the battle pass. You've got the RAAL LMG and the CX9 SMG. So a new LMG, new SMG. That's pretty cool. Excited to see how that, and a new baseball bat for the Melee fans. I'm not a big Melee guy, but there are people out there that love that shit, so they'll be excited, I'm sure.
Swinging that shit like Sammy Sosa. Crack you upside down. Like, do you remember?
Oh, and look, it looks like a new, there's something else there too. The G3 assault rifle and a nail gun. Let's go, nail gun?
Desert Eagle pistol? Nice. Yeah. So that I'm excited about that. I'm excited. Mm-hmm. I'm excited about it the baseball bat.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
It could be fun.
I grew up with Primus. My name is Mud. I'll crack you upside your head with aluminum baseball bat. My name is shit. Don't think I'm going to put that on a hockey. That shit's going on a hockey because I'm going to smack him.
I want a hockey stick. Give me a hockey stick.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. The hockey stick would be great for you. Absolutely. That's awesome.
But that's honestly really about it on the COD front. Season 4 is coming like they always do. It's going to be jam-packed. Oh, sorry.
That's why I scrolled down to it because I know you forgot it.
Yeah, so, okay, this is rumored. This is not confirmed, but there is talk of these new red doors that are going to be placed amongst Verdansk, and they're going to be used to teleport from location to location. Now,
if you remember, though, on that, so remember when they broke the new map, we went through that door to go time travel. Did. So that's pretty cool how they introduced that back to us. Mm-hmm. Kind of like it.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, it's cool. It's interesting. I'm mixed feelings on it. If you give a shit about my opinion, I suppose it's no different than when we had the subway and you just kind of jumped in the subway and then bam, you were where you wanted to be. Mm-hmm. So I guess in that aspect, it's fine. But at least the subway is real. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. We don't want to get too futuristic. Yeah. If we wanted the kid game, we'd go play Fortnite. I agree with that. Mm-hmm. I agree. But it's cool. I mean, if you're going to introduce it. I mean, I thought it was kind of cool how they tied it all in when we were looking and researching our news. So I thought that was pretty cool.
Yes, I agree. They are pretty good at doing that stuff as well. Like the storylines, if you pay attention to the little details, they're pretty good at that. So, but yeah, that is everything I've got for Call of Duty news. Nice. So get excited for season 4. It's going to be awesome. They always do a great job of pumping us full of new content. Also, make sure to break the wallet out.
That's right.
You know how that works.
Absolutely. They want to break that. They want you to break that wallet out. They want you to pay. They want you to pay.
Yeah.
And so on the Battlefield 6, or 2042, it's not 6 anymore. We actually have a title. You know, I'm not going to spend too much time on it because we obviously know we're going to spend a lot of time discussing this because
we are.
I'm a nerd about it and I am absolutely geek. So why don't we get into our new segment, The Week in Review? Tell us about this. What do we got going on exactly with this deal? What did we do?
So, you know, I briefly touched on it in the preview of the show. So basically what we did is we took some of the best, some of the funniest, some of the flat out, just great clips from the week of playing and combined them into a montage for the show. So we're going to try and do this every Friday. It's pretty cool, man. We got some really awesome clips of just straight killing and whack some guys, and then we've also got some funny ones, some funny death comms, some funny fails. We're gonna look at maybe incorporating the community in this as well. We might, if you've got a clip that you think would fit this after you guys watch this and be like, hey, you know what, I got a clip that would actually work really well, go ahead and send them, and if we think they fit the direction we're trying to go in, we might slide them in there.
Absolutely. And so we'll break it down. We'll set them up with our names on them and kind of in the recipe of, if anybody's watched Ridiculous, is that what is it? Ridiculousness on MTV. Anyway, this one we call the Tig O' Bitties.
Get you more channel points, Mrs. Steele, is them bitties.
The Tig O' Bitties. That's fucking funny.
Oh, shit.
It might be the funniest thing you've ever said. That might be the funniest shit I've ever heard. That
dick back. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. This is still smack his ass, right? Smack his ass. Oh, my God. Okay, so let's go back to this. He's talking about trying to get the bitties. Like, this is a way you can
get
the
channel bits.
Yeah, channel bits. And then he goes and brings his wife into the equation about some tickle bitties.
She wanted to know how you get more channel points because one of the things on our stream is 5,000 channel points and I give my kitties some treats live on stream. And she's like, yeah, like I want to get 5,000. Like, how do you get them? And we were like, well, you know, you gift and subs, bitties. And I was like, yeah, bitties, you know.
Which is cool, which is okay, right? You can say get the bitties misses, but now you're throwing your wife the tickle bitties.
I'm pretty sure I was high as a kite.
I don't want Rachel kicking my ass, but man, you're bringing some tickle bitties into the equation.
This is cute. Yeah, I'm pretty sure bitties pretty good. Tiggle bitties.
The tiggle bitties. That's fucking funny. Oh my god, that'd be the funniest thing you've ever said. That might be the funniest shit I've ever heard. That
I'm
sorry. Oh my god.
Oh, it's so
this
clean.
Is still smack his ass, right? Just smack his ass, right? Smack that ass. So this one. Now, the next clip that we got for this, and this is quite entertaining. This is called Stuck Twice. This is Stuck Twice, right?
Yeah. So this is from the viewpoint of our boy Maritime, who's in the chat right now.
Absolutely. Tell us all
about
this.
We were playing with him. Yeah, we were. So it was myself, you, Maritime, and our boy Super Dave playing quads. And we knew there was a team in this warehouse that you're about to see. And they actually just waxed us. You can see right now before you even start the video that we're all dead. Frilla had downed one maybe 5 seconds earlier, but then he got downed and juiced by the guy's teammates. So we're
three
all
of
dead.
Them.
There's at least three. I'm pretty
three
sure
left.
There's three.
Three
yeah.
left.
Yeah. And Chris, it's time to see if Chris can come up. So let's see if what he does here.
Let's see it. Oh, he's got a shield. He's got a shield. He's down. He's down.
You gotta keep changing the angle.
Changes the angle. Beautiful. Look at this flank. This is a beautiful.
Oh, wait, wait, wait. He got out. Oh, you're down again. You got stuck twice.
I get knocked down. Then I get up again.
Sit the fuck. Sit the fuck.
Team White, let's go. Great job.
You got get up before you get down. Oh my god, Chris just straight smacked the shit out of that squad. He smacked all three of them. Actually, what you don't see is Chris was on the other side. He killed one and then he rotates all the way back around. And he ends up getting us back after that, which was phenomenal. Maritime, what a damn great job there. It was phenomenal. Yeah. And we had several of those on Wednesday night. Wednesday night,
we were
on fire.
You boys were kicking ass. I was dragging ass, but you two were kicking ass.
Well, I think you get a pass on the nighttime because that internet you got, that string. Mm-mm. Get down or lay down. Exactly. So the next one we're going to call it Karma's a Bitch.
let me walk you guys through this one. All right.
Oh, so this is amazing.
We're rolling up in a vehicle. We know we're actually trying to get to a buy.
Mm-hmm.
Old construction. And what happens is we see a red dot, maybe, and like, oh my god, there's guys here.
Yeah.
And they're in that barn on the far end, the two-story barn. And I'm like, all right, guys, get out, and I'll try and run one over, and you guys laser them. So you guys all get out, but you get out at the house, and I drive up to the barn and obliterate me. Yeah.
Yeah.
And but what happened? See what happened?
See what happened was karma's a bitch.
Let's run the tape.
Karma's a bitch. And well, we got to set this up. You got to set this up for the guys. If anybody's seen our blooper video, I make fun of Steel. Because he always gets fucked by cars. One in particular, he kills a guy. He gets out of zero health, and he lasers a guy, and he forgot about one thing, the car. And he ended up costing us the match because the car blew up on him.
Yeah, the car was disabled, and then it you know how there's like a 5-second delay, and then it explodes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So
let's run
this.
The tape
to the left, coming in on the gun, one in, and I'm doing actually pretty good here. I laser quite a few dudes.
Fucking lasering! Look at the range on this LC-10.
One on my left.
This is disgusting.
He's down on the left. I got two on the right. Great call outs, Jeremy. Great call outs, Gorilla.
Down on the right. I got one more left. I have no plates. I'm running in.
Fuck it.
Pushing this shit.
I'm pushing it. Two tears in a bucket. Fuck it. Let's go.
Yeah, no plates. Fuck him.
He's upstairs. Upstairs. On me. On me.
Oh, nice job on the third stairs.
Behind you.
Clayton.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to baptize the last two dudes. I'm going to work the last two dudes.
I got one.
I've got him.
Yeah.
They're done.
Last one's in the burn.
The visible.
No, 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 they're not. No, they're not. No. No.
You can't forget about Dre.
No, no, can't forget about Dre. We got wrecked by blown up car. Karma's a bitch. I made fun of you.
Karma's a bitch.
And when we're cutting this up, Steele's just laughing his ass off when we're cutting this up. And he's like, because we were trying to think of names of what we're going to do. And and he's like, Jeremy, you know what? Karma's a bitch, son. Karma's a bitch. Oh, fucking amazing.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, Chris. I think you went in and got the last guy in the
Yes, you did. You got the wipe on the guys. It was again. This we had a great night all the way around. All right, so in case anybody's wondering, the next clip that we got, and this just confirms it. Steele's a bum. Steele's a bum. Listen,
that's all you guys need to know.
Listen, listen closely to this.
Yeah,
God,
you gotta listen to it.
You're a bum!
You're a bum! Wait, hold on. The dumb son of a bitch, that son of a bitch, that dumb son of a bitch eating paint chips as a kid comes back to the exact same spot. He comes back to the same spot.
You're a bum!
You're a bum, he says! Man, the death comes are fantastic in this game. I love
they are.
Them.
I don't know how people play without him. I know I've heard of people that turn him off. Fuck that.
Mm-mm. I want to hear that shit for that reason right there. To me, that is amazing. The next one is, well, things just work out. Things just work out. Watch what Steele is doing
sometimes, here. Sometimes you can manipulate people to do things. Watch
absolutely. This is quite amazing.
You're a bum.
Oh, he's a bum.
He got him. For good time.
He drops the precision, right?
Well, now, why would I do that, right?
Watch this dumb son of a bitch run into it.
Yeah. Ah! Why did I do that? Guess who I knew was coming.
It doesn't stop there. This is the best part. He's already got him hurt up top.
Yeah, my boys are pushing. They're going full cool sending this. Yeah.
He gets a double kill on a third.
Yeah, medium rare, please.
I thought that was amazing. That was absolutely amazing. And it worked out great. He got three kills right there with the precision. He got the precision. And then he gets the thermite kill. Great job, Steele. Now, this next clip, and I'm going to try and stop this in the time. Sometimes, like on this next clip, what does happen? Sometimes you just get in the best position. Sometimes you get in a great position.
Sometimes you do.
And, well, what happens with that still? What do I get to play?
Is this the arcade game?
Yes, it's the arcade. What are we playing here?
I think you're playing some whack-a-mole.
Whack-a-motherfucking-mole. Watch this, guys. We got the best position, and it's just so fun. And this all happens within a minute, 20 seconds.
Yeah, this is beautiful.
I got one down nice over down. On left.
One.
Down.
Two.
Another
three.
One down. Another one.
Four. Five.
Six. I get to play whack-a-mole. And that's all within a minute and 20. And they kept popping their heads. And I was on with the sniper that night. I really wasn't missing shots. That was Wednesday.
No.
And I did. Yep. Poor sons of bitches. It's always fun. When you get to play whack-a-mole.
We love that's our building. We love that building. That's great for doing what you just did.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Everybody just gets smacked.
Yeah.
Oh man. So now the next one, you know, if anybody plays Rebirth, it's pretty fun. You get a lot of action. You get a ton of action.
You do.
And, you know, Steel gets into his Rebirth, and, well, this is what we call a frying pan. And this happened within 45 seconds. Now, dude, I clipped it because he went down one time.
If you can get the control tower and then circle to pull towards you, you can do this all the time.
Let's go ahead and watch the frying pan. And you got one with your proxies.
Ah! No, that's a cluster.
That's right.
Yep. Yep. So I get down there, Buck revives me.
This poor bastard trying to snipe. Oh shit, I'm sorry, son. Yep. I'm sorry. Sit down!
You gotta go. Yeah. I think I had 11 or 12 that game. Oh, the next one's really good. But yeah, that Rebirth game. Rebirth is like, it's not hard if you play position in Rebirth. Like, did you see all, they look like little ants, like squirming out there in the open, right? You just mount up and let them have it. I pre-clustered them because I knew they were going to have to run into that cluster.
Yeah.
And it just caused complete chaos.
It was awesome. And so the next one.
This is a good one. This is you and I playing duos.
We're playing some duos and still just wrecks them. And we call this one back it up. Come on, girl, back it up.
Back it up.
Let's see what happens here.
Yeah. These guys were good. These guys were sweats.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. This was sweaty as hell.
I just played.
Bag it out.
Stunned him. I got down him again.
Knock him again.
Oh, yeah.
There's a camp. Can't find his buddy.
But you don't get smacked.
But it takes two to make the thing go right.
Exactly. And then we have this is kind of a nice one. He jumps
in. I'm playing Quads Rebirth by myself.
Yeah, and this is called Taking Out the Trash.
Listen to the death comms.
Pretty funny. So anybody who's ran that street sweeper, you know you can take out some trash.
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
And then his buddy comes in the door right after that. What are you doing?
Oh, nice. Nice.
Yeah.
You end up with five.
You clipped the last one because you thought I was too mean to him.
Yeah. Well, because it was still said something. I did say
some mean words.
You said something. I mean, he wasn't kind. He wasn't kind. Anyway, so this one we're playing the next one.
This is you and I and Santana, I think.
Yep.
These guys just killed the two of you, and I was the trailer, so I showed up as they were looting.
And these poor sons of bitches. This is what we call the four-piece McNugget. Don't have a revive. You're just gonna get killed twice.
Yeah, what's the point of getting up? I'm just going to pull you back down. One. Two.
Down two.
Three. Gotta go. You hear him revive. He revived. Not a good idea.
Put a new mag in.
Little four-piece McNugget on him. Oh.
Yeah.
That is awesome. So that is our week in review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Chris, I thought that was such a great suggestion. Mm-hmm. I mean, you said top 10. We didn't want to go like whole 10, but we thought, what the hell? Let's do a week in review and do it ridiculousness style. I thought it was kind of fun.
Yeah. So, no, it's great. And if you like, let us know what you guys think. If you guys like it, we want to keep doing it, but if you guys like it, that's even more motivation to keep doing them every week.
Absolutely. Well, why don't we get into the bulk of it and to our panel?
Oh, yeah, let's
We're running a little long from what we anticipated. We're going to this is going to get a little in depth. We're going to cut up we'll keep it a little short on the second half of this one. But stay with us and we'll send you out some invites here shortly. But it's time to get to our meat and potatoes. It's time to get to it. We're going to break down Battlefield 2024, the preview, the reveal.
Yeah.
What we saw. And then we have, thanks to Jack Frags, I mean, Jack Frags has obviously a lot more access to
he is Intel. Battlefield on YouTube.
He's got all the access, and so we're going to bite off of him a little bit, mm-hmm. but also give our thoughts and our opinions on some of the things that he revealed about gameplay. I don't know if you guys had a chance to check him out, but get out there and look at his videos. He's got two out now on the gameplay.
He's excellent.
And highly recommend Jack Frags. We get a lot of them. I mean, he's got millions of followers. And we have to utilize that for us because, well, we don't have that many. But let's get into the...
Hit that follow button.
Exactly. Hit that follow button. Maybe in a little bit we'll be there. Maybe 2-3 weeks. So, you know, tomato, tomato, whatever. All right. Let's get into the actual Battlefield trailer. Let's take a look at this. Boom.
Boom.
First thing I noticed, modern.
Very modern. Not futuristic, like to a degree, like crazy degree, but definitely modern.
Modern. The first thing I love about this is it's all modern. I don't have to do World War II. I don't have to do World War I and biplanes. I don't have to do those big ass tanks. It's modern. And that's what I'm looking for, right? I mean, I may be old, but damn it, I want some modern shit. Don't get me wrong. I appreciate the 70s and the 50s and the 60s as much as anybody. But I'm here. Okay, that's the first thing I noticed. The second thing, and Steel pointed this, I'll let you actually talk about it. You talked about this, was...
Yeah, it's the different... You can tell there's like kind of different factions in this cutscene. So you've got the guy in the green.
Right here?
He looks like maybe he's an ally or something. There's the guys in the white snowsuits. They kind of look like generic, maybe like AI players or just regular infantry. And then I think if you go a little longer, there's another.
Where we're looking at right here is with the skins.
Yeah, there's something unique that separates them from the other guys.
Absolutely. And then here, the flight suits.
Yeah, the flight suits, or squirrel suits, whatever you want to call them.
Yeah, the squirrel suits, whatever it is.
Yeah.
This, that right there, I'm so excited about. Because it's something that we see. It's something that we know is going to happen, right? And, you know, and, I mean, we see people jump off of buildings now. And if they introduce it into the game, I'm so excited about this. So excited about
that. And it looks like that might be a particular outfit for a particular character. So we'll get into that more as we go.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I thought they did a great job with the trailer. And the one thing that stuck out in my mind right here.
Look how big it is.
Fucking huge. Look at the size of this map. And Jack Frags touches on this on his video. But the maps are enormous. Look at this. Look at the size of what we're looking at. The total destruction, the chaos, the mayhem.
It's unbelievable how big that map is just from looking at it from an overhead view. Like, it looks insane.
Absolutely, it does. And I'm excited about that because that's Battlefield through and through. And and we found out, we didn't know this, but after watching Jack Frags, we found out why it's so big. And I'm excited about this. If anybody's seen the Jack Frags video, please throw it in there. Let us know.
Yeah.
My favorite part right here.
Yep.
Doggo. That's Doggo. That's motherfucking Fred right there. I'm getting me one of those. That's going to be motherfucking Fred. Right there. That's who he is right there. That's Doggo.
Look how badass they look.
Oh, my God. Isn't that...
Look at a little, like, it's got like a little 20-millimeter cannon or something maybe on its face. Like,
yeah.
Look at it.
It looks phenomenal. So I'm way excited about Doggo, motherfucking Fred. That's going to be motherfucking Fred. So I'm excited.
Hell yeah.
All right, so then, you know, it's great. I mean, look at the action. The tanks. We got real tanks.
Yep. No more Shermans or Panzers. Those look like M1 Abrams.
Yeah, and I love
it. They look badass.
And I love it. And I love that they're bringing it to the forefront. And I think this is what we have all been waiting for.
Yep, I think so too. Modern vehicles. Absolutely. Modern guns. Modern gear. Look at the destruction.
Yeah. That's what we want for a battlefield, right?
That's battlefield through and through.
Absolutely. This is pretty cool. I was really excited about this. Look at the
close quarters stuff.
And look at the climbing. Right? I mean, no more war zone. No more trying to climb over a rock and getting high centered on a pebble. Mm. And you can't get up like a 1 foot rock and you're just spamming it. You're like, well, the rocks are undefeated.
Right? Yeah. So more of that.
No.
You can literally climb pretty much, from what I've read and watched, you can climb pretty much anything in this.
And that's why I love, well, one of the reasons, one of the many reasons I love Battlefield. Modern guns, look at this.
Yes, that's a Remington shotgun, I think, and that's an AK-47.
Yeah, I mean, it's just absolutely phenomenal. You know, we don't have that futuristic, it's not too futuristic, right? We're not railgunning.
No, it's not Halo.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not Destiny.
And we were all, and you and I both were worried about that. You know, the first time you watched it was just, it was just something that we were worried about. And then, you know, you watch the gameplay in this, quite phenomenal. I'm excited.
My initial reaction was like, oh God, I think they might have gone too far with the future stuff. But after watching it a few times and then listening to Jack break down everything frame by frame, I feel so excited for this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at Surfer. Rocks plus one, me, zero. Get it?
Yeah.
100% on Warzone. And that's one of the, I mean, that's just not Warzone's.
Call of Duty's always had dog shit climbing mechanics. Yeah, it's always been ass.
And that's why I'm so damn excited about this right here. Yeah. You know, just the trailer is fantastic. Close quarters, great gunfight, great patterns. And then,
The patented Battlefield dog tag ripping for an execution.
Give me those tags! I can't tell you how many tags. Yeah, that is my MO when I do that shit. Give me them tags. No, I loved it. It's awesome. And the next one that we get to here, and the maps are awesome. The one thing. Mm-hmm. This is pretty cool. Look at the vehicles. Look at the multiple vehicles that we're able to see here.
They're like hover something, maybe. I forget the name. The penguins. There's fucking penguins. There's fucking penguins.
Absolutely. And this is the leak scene. This is the leak scene. That we've
the
been talking launch. About for weeks on end. I'm excited about this. Yep. How cool is this? Mm-hmm. And we'll discuss this a little bit.
Maybe he's launching satellites for my new internet.
Fuck off, that's funny.
Fucking Elon that's funny. Musk launching,
Look at, he's
launching
like, fuck
Starlink
it.
Satellites.
I gotta get still taken care of right now. That's fantastic. That might be the second funniest thing you said. But this is the scene. It's awesome. I love everything about it.
Look at the smoke that comes out of this cover.
The detail.
Yeah.
The detail, the way it is, the way it's looking. Mm-hmm. What a great building. Look at the sands coming in. I felt like this was Dawnbreaker. This has a lot of Dawnbreaker feel to me. And I thought it was fantastic. Mm-hmm. One of the awesome things about this, the little bird's back.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and that's in Apaches as well.
The little bird, the Apache, they're back.
Remember the little bird? It used to get abused. So if there was ever anyone who was good with a little bird, they would just abuse the shit out of that BF4.
So we played with this cat called Fluffy. Kill a gorilla. Yeah. I think his name was Fluffy. If Kill is watching, please speak up to make sure I get it correctly. But Fluffy would get 20 to 30 kills hands down every single time, like clockwork, be 30 and
with
0.
With the miniguns on it?
And just and he could fly underneath those little, the overpass, or the little over and underpasses. He would try, there was a nighttime one, and you had a, my gosh, why can't I remember it? Forget about it. But he would fly through the warehouses. There was a nighttime one on Battlefield 4 and a daytime one, if anybody remembers that. And he would fly through there and kill people. as he's flying through the warehouses. It's exciting.
Yeah, it is. Nice surf. Yeah, they're great. Actually, Outlaw was telling us when we were talking to him that that's how him and Cal became friends, because Cal got tired of him killing him every single server he'd get into, because Outlaw would fly around in the mini bird and just wax everyone. So Cal sent him a friend request and said, "You want to play with me?"
Right. And how do you not get pissed off at the little bird? And he's pretty fucking good with it. I remember him telling us all about that. Absolutely. So anyway, let's start.
Yeah.
You know, a couple things I like about it is they got the ATV coming up, right?
You mentioned
that. So it's not too futuristic. We still got the vehicles. Nope. Right?
We still got
modern vehicles, not futuristic.
All real ammo. There's no way.
Yeah.
Look at this. This is so cool. The destruction, man.
We got the F-35.
Mm-hmm.
What a great scene, because this was one of the great scenes from Battlefield 4.
Mm-hmm.
This right here. I've seen it done many, many times, and I love it. Take it. Take it.
Kablam. Dying
out. And then I'm going to jump back in my plane and fly out like nobody did, like a bomb.
Yeah, like a bomb.
Okay, yeah.
Let's pause this. Gives, as far as I'm concerned, this is the most information you can get from everything we've seen, is this scene right here. Pay close attention to the what differentiates all these operators that you're about to see.
So you got skin. You got one skin here. Mm-hmm. You got one skin here. 2, 3, 4, 5 skins. Mm-hmm. That whole 6 skins. 6 different skins. 6 different, maybe, specialists. We learned
all with different equipment. Yeah.
Yeah, we learned they were called specialists. I called them operators, but we found out later. What a customization. What a customization right off the bat. And how many different specialists that we're going to have in the actual game. I'm excited.
Yeah, me too.
And what you said something about this. You were talking about
all the vegetation. Look how real the vegetation and the trees and shit look. Like I don't know if the video does it enough justice, but it's incredible.
The details, the destruction, everything in between. The one thing I like about this, and we're gonna see it on the next one, they interproduced the weather events. It looks like there's a tornado. And it changes the whole dynamic of the map. Look at it get darker. Look at the details.
And the rain.
Yeah.
Look at the debris from the map that gets sucked into the tornado. There's some more operators, close-ups and operators, specialists. Yeah, look at this. Unbelievable. Look at the destruction. Yeah, holy shit. Oh, and then we got our squirrel buddy again.
Absolutely. I think it's phenomenal.
Yeah, it is. Oh, man, I can't wait. If anyone's lucky enough to get on that alpha, I'm very jealous.
Oh, 100%.
Mm-hmm. Too phony? What do you mean too phony?
Oh, well, we'll have that discussion here in just a few minutes. So we spent a lot of time on that. For sure we have. We're going to briefly go through Jack Frags and give you the highlights. Not necessarily in with the film, just because it's been a while. We spent a lot of time on that, but we're going to go through the Jack Frags. So Jack Frags, he played this game. He's actually played it. He's actually seen the gameplay. He's gone through it all. A couple high points of Jack Frags. I'll let you start off with exactly what you saw with him. So we had
Jack Frags touches on a lot of stuff. We're not going to get into everything, but some major things that are important, I think, are we're sticking with the Frostbite engine. That's been Battlefield's game engine for a while now. It's beautiful. It's probably one of the better game engines out there. Mm-hmm. It's what allows them to do all the crazy destruction and details with the maps and all that stuff. So that's huge.
And then
this
we
is going to be.
Go ahead.
You got the no pats.
Yep.
Yeah, I was going to touch on your doggos. They're called no pats. Yeah, at both the allies and the enemies are going to have them. And you can see your multiplayer only. There's not going to be a campaign. Me personally, I'm not too beat up about it. I never really played the Battlefield campaigns anyway. Couldn't be bothered. I think you're on the same mindset as well.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, I'm not playing it. The campaigns. I don't.
No.
I can't remember a time I played the campaign.
Yeah.
And so I'm really excited it doesn't bother me, but what I am really excited about is this is a sandbox model, right? This means there's really no limitations on what they're going to, you're going to do in
an
customization.
Open world.
And that says a lot to me, right? This says a lot to me that there's going to be a lot of dev support. Mm-hmm. If you're making sandbox models out of a game, that means this is a long-term game. They're putting a lot of resources, a lot of capital into it, and therefore they're going to give a lot of dev support to this game, and I'm way excited about that because that means this game is not going to falter like Firestorm and Battlefield 5.
Yeah, and speaking of that, we learned that this game has been in development since 2018, so pretty much right after they dropped Battlefield 5, they already started working on this. So they've been at this for over 3 years, which gives me a lot of hope and promise because that's a long time to develop a game.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's going to be the one thing with this is it's going to be 128 players. 128 mm-hmm. players on PC.
There's
and
a caveat
Gen.
To that. Yes.
What is the caveat?
Only on PS5, Xbox X, and PC. If you're stuck on PS4 and Xbox One, you're going to have to play reduced lobbies for player counts as well as map size. It's going to be 64 players and reduced maps.
And the one thing that raises a question for me, we talked about this, is we didn't know that raises kind of a red flag. Is this going to be cross-platform? Hopefully it is on the back end of it with the next gen consoles and PC, but it does raise a little bit of worry that, well, they've got two different games. Will they have two different games for console versus PC? I think you have to not rely on what you're doing and say, we got to have it all across the board. So that's something that I'm a little nervous about, I will say.
Well, while you're on guns here, we might as well touch on how the gun customization is going to work.
Yep.
So you will be able to change up your attachments on your guns at any time. Yeah, plus system on guns. So if you are in a long range fight and you need that three times and a longer barrel and a better stock, and then all of a sudden you find yourself in a building doing close combat, you can quickly swap out the attachments, put that shorter bell on there, maybe a no stock and a red dot or iron sights before you even go in the building. Now, I love that. You have a different opinion.
I don't. Well, one of the things about that really frustrates me is you have to plan for your map. And the fact that you can customize, so if you want to land out in XYZ and you need a sniper, and then all of a sudden you know that you're going to go into close quarters, you get to flip it. No, that's not what planning is about. You got to plan for it. And I don't like that. I like pick your shit, and that's what you got to deal with because you need to plan for your map and there's strategy involved. When you when you can customize on the fly, there's zero strategy. And that's what Battlefield is strategy. And that's what makes, in my opinion, that's what makes Battlefield fun. So
that's fair. I can see. I can dig it.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
And sticking with that, we may as well talk about the how the vehicles work.
Yeah. So the vehicles, they are seat based. So you have to have they work better with each person filling the seats. So whether you're on a gunner seat, whether you're on a tank seat, how many other vehicles or seats are in the vehicle, they actually work better according to Jack Frags. I thought it was pretty freaking awesome.
It's an incentive to play as a team, right? If you're in a squad of four, you guys should all, and you want to roll a tank or you want to roll a helicopter or something, it's incentive for everybody to get in it, which I love.
Absolutely.
And then, but there's one other little thing. Again, I love this. You not so much, but apparently the vehicles won't just spawn in the in your regular spawn anymore. You can call them in via tablet anywhere on the map. Now, there's Jack mentioned that he doesn't quite understand this fully, but he is speculating that it's going to be a reward system. You're almost like a kill streak. You're going to have so many points to be able to call in a tank or a helicopter or a jet or what have you. So, that'd be cool.
I don't like it, right? I don't like it because there's two caveats to this. There's two scenarios.
Yeah.
Number one, if you're going to have extra vehicles and have an emphasis, and Jack Frag said there seems to be an emphasis on vehicles. And so if you're going to do that, you damn well better give me solo, run an assault or whatever it is, enough weapons and enough resources to kill a tank
enough
on my
ammo.
Own. I have to have it.
Because that was a big problem in 5.
And one. Yeah, you couldn't. Yeah.
You didn't spawn enough with rockets.
No.
Yeah.
And that's
bullshit. You would have to drop your ammo box and reload your Panzer. Yeah. And then shoot it again.
Yeah, you got it. And in Battlefield 4, you know, I knew it took 4 laws. If somebody had my laser, the laser on there, it took 3. And you damn well better give me enough. The second part is, I don't like them being able to call it in. If you can call in, because I just spent this time kicking this vehicle's ass. I'm an assault. I'm a ground troop, right? I just took the time to kick its ass, and then you can call it in. And now it takes away your ability to recapture the zones, recapture your objectives, because they can call a vehicle and you can't push forward. So if you're getting your ass kicked as a team and you start, you know, an objective and now you need to push forward to get more, you can't do that because they're calling in vehicles behind you and going to kick your ass behind. Sorry,
I could see it getting out of control. I hope there's some sort of cooldown system in place where if you have the points, there should be a maximum capacity for vehicles per map or even per team at one point.
Yeah.
So I could totally understand why you're wary about that, because if there's like if you just took out a convoy of tanks on a control point and you captured it, next thing you know, they're all back again. That would be kind of demoralizing.
Absolutely. And then you're getting your ass smacked from behind, and I don't like it. Mm-hmm. I got issues with that. Anyway, that comes from anybody who played Black Ops 1, the Russians and the zombies. He's like, the zombies would come touching me. He's like, no touchy. I have issues. And I thought that was the funniest shit I've ever heard. Okay. Anyway. So, we'll just move through this real quick. So there's destruction level events. There's interactive mechanisms through the whole gameplay. You can get into a crane, move boxes. You can raise and lower bridges. You can change doors, lock sections off. And it's all, you can jump.
There's rockets that go off randomly. Right. Sometimes they function, sometimes they don't.
And with that big rocket that you go up, it changes the dynamic of it. Sometimes it has one outcome. Sometimes it has a different outcome. And I believe he said there was 3 different outcomes that he saw or was informed about, I should say. I don't know I don't know his there because I wasn't, or I don't know what he saw. I wasn't there. The maps. Why don't you tell us about the maps? There's 7 maps that we know of, right?
We got introduced to 7 maps. There's the Kaleidoscope. Am I saying
Kaleidoscope?
Kaleidoscope. Manifest, which is the shipyard. That's the one with where you can jump in a crane and operate the damn thing. Orbital.
Yep.
Word soup. That's the rocket launching one that we've been showing the leaks for some time. Discarded.
Yep.
Renewal, which is kind of cool. It's like a desert / farm.
Yeah.
It's really neat. Hourglass, which is Qatar. We saw that in the reveal video with the sand dunes outside of the big city. And then Breakaway, which is Antarctica. I believe they're fighting over oil and gas or something like that. You saw that in the first cutscene.
Yeah.
And those are the maps. Pretty amazing that we got to see 7 different maps. But Jack got to see 7 different maps all ready to go.
Yeah. No, and I thought that was quite amazing. I thought that was awesome.
That's the Egypt one there.
Yeah. And the thing that they saw, he said there's going to be 10 different specialists that he knows of. There's 4 so far. One is assault, engineer, recon, and support. This is one thing I do not like about this. This is one thing I'm going to just throw it out there. I don't like the fact, because he said that you can have any weapon you want in any class. You like that. I didn't.
I do.
I liked in Battlefield 4 where they had specific weapons, you know, LMG on support, sniper for recon, but then you had a group of universal weapons that you could pick into there. And I thought that was quite awesome. Sorry, we've got our group already joining in.
Our panel starting.
Absolutely.
Showing up.
Let's switch over to the panel real quick. There he is. And then the next one was, is there is going to be a freed and paid version. What is that?
So there'll be a free battle. It'll be very similar to Call of Duty. So they've got the free battle pass, which is you'll get, you know, whatever guns, maybe a few cosmetics, nothing crazy, but you'll get all the, it won't be a pay to play per se, because you'll get all the guns.
Okay.
But then there'll be a paid one, like you see in Warzone and Call of Duty, where you get all the cosmetics, you get the guns. Hey, Surf, and you get everything else.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We gotta send it. Chris never got his yet.
That's hilarious. Well, I don't have his email, so we'll get in there and get that.
I sent it to you. You should have it in your Facebook chat.
Oh, then of course I wouldn't have it right there. But anyway, so back to that. So I don't know how I feel about having the universal weapons. What do you think about that?
I like it, honestly. Like, if you want to run a sniper rifle and when you run medic, like, who cares? But I mean, I see you're all about the authenticity. You don't want it to be like that. And I can appreciate that. But there's definitely been times when I'm playing Battlefield and I want to run an AR, but I also want to have an ammo box, or I'm running an AR and I want to have the medic dark gun or whatever they're gonna have, right?
Yeah. No, that's exactly how I feel about it. So that's that.
Yeah.
And we are going to jump into our panel chat. I've got some invites out. So if you guys are watching, please jump in. We've got Pete. Go ahead and turn your mic on, Pete.
What's up, boys?
What is up, Surfer?
Let's go.
What's going on, man?
Right? I'm excited.
Welcome to the party.
There
he
is.
Welcome to the party, pal.
Chris. I got to invite him real quick. Let's get this in here. So this is us trying this out for the first time. And it's a...
Yeah.
Hopefully it works out well for us.
I think it will. John, if you're there, here, I'll message John.
Yeah, Chris... All right. Is that an underscore underneath that? Yeah, it is. Yeah, Hotmail. All right, so Chris, you should have yours. I'm sending it now.
Beautiful.
How was your day today, Surf?
Yeah, amazing.
Yeah,
absolutely amazing.
Anything fun? Anything exciting happened with it?
I was just chilling, playing some Warzone and testing out some weapons and jumping into Plunder and trying to figure out if I want to do the AK 47U or stick with my LC-10 or my MAC-10.
Okay.
Hey, Santan. Oh, Chris just redeemed kitty treats, so I got to go get a kitty to give her some.
Wait a minute. Perfect Santana, timing. Is that you?
And it is Santana.
Hey, girl. Hey. What is up, girl? How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Nothing short of amazing. Oh my gosh, look at this, man. We are surrounded by Canucks, Surf.
What's going on?
Watch out. The maple syrup is starting to drip.
Right? Exactly. Can you hear us?
How's it going, Dixie?
Okay. There he is. Okay, boys. Okay, there is so much feedback. I'm watching you guys. Just one second here.
Are we getting feedback on the?
No, just mute.
No.
Mute the stream.
Yeah. Holy shit, man! I was in the past and the future, like.
Yeah, you gotta mute that stream, bro. You can't watch and speak at the same time. We learned that shit the hard way.
Man, I can't even walk and talk. Jesus Christ, boy.
I know.
All right, Chris, this is for you. We're doing the kitty treats. So hold on.
Chris, did you get that? Did you get that invite, Chris? I hope it's the correct one.
Okay, you gotta move over a bit.
Here comes the family.
I'm gonna send it to him again. Maybe send it to him Facebook again or the Messenger still. I hope I got the correct one, but let's get started. Let's get started real quick. While he's doing that, I'm going to take my two. We're going to introduce everybody to the panel here. First off is Surfer. So Surfer, you and I met on SoCal Love on his stream. How did that come about? What was that all about?
So you're running on his games, and he had introduced you to me saying, hey, I think this guy might be okay, you know, to play with. He's all right. And he said, you know, why don't you look him up, you know, try to kind of hook up a couple games with him. And we started rolling together off of his recommendation. And it's been like peanut butter and jelly ever since.
Absolutely.
With me, you, and Steel. It's been amazing.
Oh, it's been nothing short of amazing.
Yeah, man, we've been having wicked games. I love
super
our squad.
Fun. Oh, super fun.
The vibe playing with you is nothing short of just exactly what I want to do every time I play. It's been a pleasure for probably like 2-3 months, maybe there.
Yeah, pretty close.
Yeah,
pretty
close. Exactly. That's awesome. And then Santana. Now this is my girl. This is my girl. Love
that
her.
Is his girl.
Absolutely. Santana, why don't you introduce yourself and tell them how we all met?
I don't even remember how we met. We met on Battlefield.
Yeah, Firestorm.
Battlefield 5, right?
Yep, on Firestorm. I don't remember who introduced us. I have no idea who introduced us together.
I don't know. I was, Killa and I were trying to figure it out too.
Okay.
He said that he was playing. I was playing with someone named like Deer Hunter or something.
Yeah.
And you guys joined.
Deer Rut is his name. Deer Rut. We used to play with him, and you—that's right. It was Deer in a Rut, and we played. And we used to go. So with Santana, we had to go to one spot in Firestorm every time.
Not every time.
Where did you like to go, Santana?
Every time. What do you mean? What do you mean? Not every time. The circles up on the far. The circles way up on the far right of the map. The up top above, like the farms and.
The farms! I love farms.
But it was up above the farms that we used to go there.
Oh, the bunkers.
Back on this side, we call them the fire circles. And there's a radio tower. It's just above the farms by what was that one that DK used to always go to?
The building.
DK Island.
No, the DK, the building, what was
Odenburg.
Odenburg. So it's oh, down from Odenburg.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. There's like that big watchtower.
And the watchtower's just on the other side. Mm-hmm.
I loved going there. That was Vibe Hill. We used to call that when I was in Vibe. There's Chris.
There
Look
you go.
Look at him at the beach.
Absolutely. So Santana's
you missed the kitty treats. I'll do it again for you, Chris.
So, still, tell us about these two cats. I just met them 3
years
ago. Yeah,
so
guys.
This is down on the bottom. We got Maritime Mogul. That's my buddy Chris. We went to high school together and didn't really hang out too much. He was neighbors with one of my best friends. And I think he found me on Twitter. I was talking about Warzone or something. He's like, hey, dude. Hey, Bagheera.
Oh, by the way, Santana is that's Bagheera, and that's her boyfriend right there. She loves
that's our baby boy.
Yeah,
yeah.
Go ahead, Steel. Go ahead.
But yeah, so we found each other on Twitter again. He's like, hey, like I see you play Warzone. You want to play? And then we started playing, and then he introduced me to his boys. They're all military guys. So he got me in there with them, and we started playing. And fuck, we were for a while there. We were playing every friggin' day.
Awesome. And now, what's your take on the friendship, brother?
I can't argue with that. He's been in the same school system. He's my next door neighbor's best friend.
Yeah.
Didn't have a whole lot to say about that. And he just, I don't know, we tripped over each other on Twitter, probably picking on the Leafs or something. And it seemed like he had no friends. He had someone to play video games with, so he reached out to me, and he was like, hey, man, we should play sometime. Next thing you know, he's in a Facebook chat with all my buddies in the forces, and we have the unhealthy habit of putting in probably 30 days on this game since November together.
Nice.
Yep.
Yeah, and let's not lie about it, right? He did not say, do you want to go play some games? He said, hey, you want to go give it a rip, babe, bud? You know, that's exactly
how there's a good came there's out. A good chance that's how it went. But yeah, so that's how Chris and I started playing, and then fantastic. my boy Dixie down there, Dixie and I go way back. I've known John since
2011, 2012,
yeah. I met Dixie in Corner Brook, Newfoundland. We went to tech school together for forestry, and then when we graduated, we both moved to Fredericton, New Brunswick, to go to the same university to do our degree programs there. And yeah, we hung out a lot. Just a riot. If you know Dixie, he's fucking crazy, buddy.
The craziest.
Yeah, he has no qualms about saying anything with whoever's around. But honestly, just a stand-up guy, fucking brilliant guy. He runs his own photography business. He's also a district manager up in Norman Wells for the government running
lands.
All their awesome. Doing mining and all that shit. Just a cool dude. And yeah, man, we love having him in the squad. He's a fucking riot.
He's one of my favorite. Tell us, so how did you get into the photography there, Dixie?
Well, when I graduated there and started getting a full-time job, I just decided that wildlife is my passion.
Yeah.
So like Ian said, we did do forestry together, but I started out fish and wildlife first and then transferred and did forestry to get a job. Because wildlife jobs are
right? There's no jobs. Wildlife's a hobby. I used to call it
right. And then, so Ian did the forestry degree at UMB, and I did environment and natural resources, where I majored in wildlife conservation as well. So, again, wildlife.
Right.
But it all worked out. It got me this job here in the NWT. And just before I moved here, though, I got a camera. It's probably been about 3 years now, and like passion for wildlife. Like I'm an avid hunter. Like I love getting outdoors and just being out there and all that good stuff. So started all that and just wanted to take pictures. And up here, being from Newfoundland, wildlife everywhere. Like you can't drive the highway without seeing a moose. So
right.
It's pretty crazy. But being here in the NWT, there's more animals than people, man. It's beautiful. The scenery is crazy. Let's see here. I'll change up one of my pictures here right quick to give everyone a cool little look.
Yeah, please do. And one of the things I wanted to ask you for everybody, because you guys have got to see this, cats. I really wanted to make a point to promote.
How do we find your shit, John? Like,
beautiful.
You sell it online.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Facebook and Instagram.
What's it called, though?
Jonathan Gillingham Photography. So yeah, I guess I should have just kept my name.
Yeah, no, look,
there's a musk ox.
You guys have got to go check out his pictures. His pictures are phenomenal.
Yeah,
he is
unreal.
A very, very talented human being, and I'm very envious. And he does a great effing job. He does a great.
Yeah, look at the Northern Lights.
Yeah,
holy.
And that's his. That's his.
These are all his. Yeah,
yeah. This is all him. So, well, Steele, why don't we get into Battlefield? Why don't we get into everybody's take on Battlefield? You know, one of the things I'll start off with, and I know for a fact, Surfer and I had talked a little bit about Battlefield, and I want to start off with Surf, because you have a little bit of a mixed history with Battlefield. When I say mixed, just not playing. What is your opinion? We'll go around the horn because I want everybody's opinion on this. What is your opinion on that? On the reveal?
So super quick. My history in Battlefield is I ran a clan of 100 people in Battlefield 2142.
Okay.
And we had a pretty called the Killjew clan. And we had a pretty extensive background in playing the game and loved it. Absolutely loved it. And that was my first environment to actually real PC gaming and gaming multiplayer. And then really kind of got a little bored with it going up until like Battlefield 3 and 4. And then I got really excited again.
Yeah.
The hype on it was like, let's go, you know? So we got into Battlefield 3 and 4 and that was super fun. And then it just kind of, for me, it kind of died off a little bit.
Absolutely.
And then I've kind of heard the same thing from a lot of people around that they kind of felt the same way. So I was like, okay, well, I wasn't the only one, but we all had kind of the same hype. So I'm really hoping that this one will really bring us what we're looking for. I love that Motley Crue entry.
Right? Give me the girl.
Yeah, me too.
Oh my God, the audio for it and the video for everything that they do.
Yeah.
And jumping out of the jet. And I remember jumping out of the jets and being able to RPG somebody and flying the helicopters and stuff. I'm looking forward to it. It looks really amazing. And I know with their graphics and their crew that they'll do a really great job. And they really got to beat Battlefield. They got to beat Warzone, and they know they do. They know they're up against a monster, and so they really have to really put their best foot forward for this. So I am looking forward to it, and the play and what they got in the video and the new reveals. So we'll see what they got to come.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, no, that absolutely. I couldn't agree more, man. They have to kill it, and I think they will. I really do. I really think they will.
I think they will too.
So let's go to, honestly, probably the person who's played the most Battlefield in the last 6 or 8 months than anyone else on here, but Santana. what's your take on the reveal and where the franchise is at, and what are you hoping to get out of the new Battlefield?
I really enjoyed the reveal. I'm really looking forward to it. I know my crew for Firestorm is looking forward to it too. But a couple of them are hoping for like a hardcore mode. Really getting sick of being spotted all the time on every single game.
Yeah, players are just abused so much. Like, you just...
I'm hoping that they can step up to the plate with a better Battle Royale. Because I do really like Firestorm a lot better than Warzone, but it's just filled with modders and it's
the player base isn't there anymore.
Yeah,
for sure. And one thing that we I think we failed to touch on this when we were breaking it down before we started here, but one thing Jack gets into at the end of his video is they mentioned to him specifically that there is no Battle Royale built into the game. Mm-hmm. Now, a lot of people got upset and kind of overreacted and panicked about that because they took it as, DICE and EA coming out and saying we're not making a BR. But I think what they're going to do is they're looking at what Call of Duty did. And on day one on Modern Warfare, there was no BR. They kept it hush-hush for a really long time. And slowly, leaks started to come out, and eventually, bam, it was announced. Like, a week from now, we're gonna have Warzone.
Yeah.
And I think that's what Battlefield's going to do, and that will be a standalone download. It will be free to play. You won't have to buy Battlefield 2042 to play it. I don't think. This is obviously just me speculating, but. I can't wait. I think they're gonna absolutely destroy the BR. It's gonna be amazing.
I hope so. Dixie, what's your take on the reveal? How did you feel about that?
It looked cool. I'm probably the only person ever that's never played Battlefield ever.
Oh shit! Okay, but that's interesting though, because
what a great take. But that's good. Okay, what do you got? Wait, how the fuck do you never play Battlefield? Number one, number two, what is your take on it then?
So
my whole thing is I used to always just play Call of Duty and NHL. That's it. I was playing NHL or Call of Duty, or I was outside being normal and not video gaming.
Yeah.
Hey, fuck you, speak for yourself.
Ever since COVID, I've just became the worst. Like, always gaming, like, with the boys and you guys and whoever, but so like I always played video games, I guess, but mostly like when I grew up, like we just played video games on rainy days, you know?
Yeah.
We didn't. But, college days and university, we got into it a bit more and stuff. But yeah, never, like I said, mainstream gamer, dude.
Wow.
So what do you think about the, like, obviously you watched the reveal and like what were some of your initial thoughts or reactions to what you saw in the reveal?
It looks pretty cool. Like, as you guys know, I fucking hate the goddamn fucking vehicles in any game. Oh, I think it's fucking stupid.
Well, so, you might not enjoy this.
Warzone, for example, every fucking time someone gets in a helicopter, I end up dying and I hate it. Anytime that I try to drive a vehicle, I end up dying and I hate it. So, I'm never allowed to drive.
You're not allowed to drive.
I shouldn't say much. No. I can't drive for
No. So. You're not allowed to drive ever. I've drove with you once and I said never again. No.
Well, I think we're playing there and what was it? Nathan. He met when we were streaming. The last time I was streaming you boys, he's like, "Don't let him drive. Yeah. Don't let him drive."
Right?
And he killed us.
Yeah, exactly. No, 100%.
I hate the vehicles. Hands down, I hate the vehicles. I can't stand them. I hate everyone who drives them. I think they all should just get off the game and use their two legs in a heartbeat.
There you go. So, are you gonna get in? Are you gonna get into Battlefield then, or no?
I got a lot of disposable income. I'll join.
All right, that's fair. What about you?
Well, if you want to hang out with us.
Yeah, what about Chris? I would love to hear Chris's take on this.
Well, I've been playing Battlefield since Battlefield 2, way back on the PS2 days, probably grade 9 or 10-ish.
Okay.
So I've always preferred Battlefield over Call of Duty. The only reason I've been playing Call of Duty is Dave, Super Dave and I got bored of playing it every day for 3 years. And yeah. One day, Dave tried to force me into Warzone, and I was really reluctant, real hesitant to try and play another Call of Duty game, especially after they introduced jetpacks a couple games ago. So the only reason I'm playing it now is because of COVID. You know, you lost all your friends. You can't go see them anyway, so I almost need the social aspect. But as for the reveal, generally very excited. The only thing I don't like is when I said too phony. Yes, it's a stable in the last couple of Battlefields, but I really don't like jumping out of an aircraft, shooting an RPG at somebody, and getting back in. So being military myself, and Natasha upstairs will say it, I am one of the people you don't take to a movie theater when watching anything military movie. I'm like,
You're that guy.
Yeah, I'm that guy. So when I see somebody jump out of a jet, and I've probably been killed by a few of them, so it made me real angry, turn the TV off kind of a day. But
yeah,
that's the only thing that holds me back. Other than that, I'm excited to get away from Warzone. I don't know how long I've been telling Steel I hate this game.
Yeah.
Just as a repetition, I was waiting for a new map. Sick of Verdansk, Rebirth Island didn't do it for us. So I'm over the moon, and hearing what you guys introduced about the 7 maps at least to start off the get-go and 10 operators, it's got me over the moon. I'll be buying a new console just for that game.
Oh, absolutely. I'm beyond excited. I'm a Battlefield nut. I think it's great. I don't like the bunny hopping. I like the straightforward. Let's get at it. Let's get tactical and let's get at it. So I agree with you 100%. And I'm excited. And the only thing that is apprehensive to me is I'm worried that it's not cross-platform. And I think they have to, though. Wouldn't anybody's opinion on that? Wouldn't they have to do it?
If they don't, no one's going to play. Everyone's going to continue playing Warzone.
That's true.
Everyone's different. Like, people got Xboxes, people play on PC, people play PS4, PS5, whatever have you. Like, I don't, like, besides Ian, I don't know anyone else that has a PS4, or 3 or 4 people at home, and then everyone else has a PC or an Xbox, so it's just the way it is, you know?
Absolutely.
It's the way gaming's going, right? You would be foolish to be the one person who doesn't make cross-play, right? Like, you look at all the other games, you got new PUBG coming out, you look at Apex, you look at Fortnite, you'd be absolutely insane. I mean, maybe there's something we're missing. Maybe it's more complicated on the Frostbite engine to run crossplay, but
I was hoping that was why it took them so long to release this game. Was they were getting ready to release the PlayStation edition, the Xbox edition, the PC edition, and then all of a sudden Warzone came out and they're like, oh my god, crossplay, we have to take more time, sit back and do this the right way, because Warzone being as successful as it is with all those kids, like, I find a lot of us adults play the Battlefield games. I haven't found too many kids in Battlefield screaming profanities at me when I kill them.
Right?
I'm an adult and I scream profanity.
You're special.
I love hot miking people. It's my favorite.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. One of the things that we're worried about, and I think we can speak on this, and I'm going to have Santana and Surfer talk about this as well. And Santana, what is the status of Firestorm now with the cheaters, with the modders, with that? What's going on? I know you play that all the time. What's happened there?
It's just maybe 75% of the games we play, we come up against modders, and you can hear their guns.
Uh-huh.
Rapid fire and one A1s. Like,
yeah.
If you're going up against that, you don't have a chance. Mm-hmm. And they also have cheats where they can see where you are on the map at all times. So that takes out the whole point of the game. Like, there's no secrecy in where you are. There's no vantage points. There's nothing. There's no strategy because some asshole's on the map and knows where you are all the time.
Yeah.
No, absolutely.
Yeah, I won't say any names. Or me, maybe I will. But there were some prominent players when we all played.
He was number
together.
One. He was number one in the world.
He was
on
number
wins.
One in wins, number one in kills, and he used to use Cronus. And, yeah. And there's so I was looking the other day. I was down a rabbit hole on YouTube, and this video came up about Cronus and the new Cronus Zen. And I was like, fuck it, I'll give this a watch and see what this is all about. And they've got it so easy now that a 10-year-old kid can set up a Cronus and to the point where you can have it customized for 10 different loadouts. You can pick the game you want to use it for. You can pick every individual gun. And it has an LED display screen, so you don't have to, like, flick through the buttons like on the old one. I think you just had to press, like, a sequence of buttons. But and this thing's on back order on Amazon for, like, 3 months because it sold out.
Unreal.
So, I'm really scared about console. Yeah, I'm really worried about first-person shooters and where we go from here, because as long as these things exist, and they cost $70 Canadian on Amazon, you got
nothing.
It on your doorstep in 2 days,
that's
right?
Nothing,
like,
right?
Yeah.
A weekend at the bar.
Every little high school kid has these things, right? Because they don't give a shit about integrity and gaming,
fun.
Right? They don't care. So that's what you're running up against on console.
And
people love to say, I'm on console, how am I cheating? I'm like, bro, do you know what?
I can understand how kids could do it, but, like, grown-ass fucking men.
Yeah, it's pretty sad.
That's my girl. That's my girl right there.
Let's go. Get him.
Like, I love it.
It's frustrating, for sure.
So hopefully they have some. It's so hard to detect those because they run off of USB. Basically, what the consoles read, like they have masking built into them. So what your console thinks it is, it's like a keyboard or a mouse or whatever. It has no idea that it's a cheat.
Yeah.
So hopefully there's something they can do, like an update or something like that on the PS5 and Xbox X, that they can somehow detect these things. But until that happens, first person shooters are just, it's not looking good.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I like how in Warzone you can at least block a player, but in Firestorm, like, there's nothing you can do. You're just stuck with it. You can't block anyone.
No. And that's unfortunate with that. And with that being said about Warzone, so Surf, what is your take on what is happening in Warzone with hackers? We ran into one the other night and you got fucking lasered for no reason and we should have won the game. What's your take on the hackers?
Yeah,
I remember that in that last circle, and we totally would have had it if those guys wouldn't have been just headshot full on. Every one of us just downed us immediately. I mean, honestly, we're all frustrated by it. That's a given. The game, we love the game, obviously, and we love to hate it at the same time.
Yeah.
It's a love-hate relationship with the game, but it's not really, I don't think, all the game. It's a lot of it with the game, but it does have to do with the hackers and PC players and whatnot. I play on PC. I've never thought of hacking. I've heard little murmurings of Cronus Max and this stuff. I've never looked into it. Mm-hmm. That's just not my jam. I don't do that. I play to play. I'm really not that great of a player. I'm okay. But I want to play to have fun, and I play for the teamwork and all that. And really what keeps bringing me back is the communication with guys like you, guys like Steel, guys like, you know, Martin Mogul and Santana and everybody that's involved in the game. It's like
yeah,
a
big, not me.
It's like a family.
Yeah.
No, totally yeah. like you. No, that's exactly
I don't want to play with you. I don't want to play with you no more.
That attitude, I love that. Let's get it. And squatting up and leading and just being a part of the whole community, and that's what keeps bringing me back. And I think that's really what keeps bringing a lot of people back is just the interaction mm-hmm. between all of us. And it's really an organic, completely organic situation as we're mm-hmm. playing. People are making moves yep. based on instant decisions, like instantaneous, like half a second, millisecond decisions. And we're yeah. playing to the best of our abilities and to the best of our knowledge and what we learn
yeah.
from our friends and all the people around us. That's what keeps bringing me back is interaction and leading and being those people. And, you know, I'll take the dives from the hackers and the people that are using, you know, what they're not supposed yeah. to and whatnot. But yeah. we do get a lot of games where we're just like, you know, we're like, whatever, hit restart. That's yeah. what they have it for. It sucks. But we'll do it in you know, what, seven yep. times out of ten, we're getting games that we're pretty fair with and yeah. we're busting the asses of the hackers.
Yeah, so. yeah, absolutely. and that yeah. follows it up with the next question that I have, and it's going to be with there's two here, and this one's for Dixie. Dixie, what do you think Warzone has to do to combat this, to stay alive, because Battlefield's coming out? What do you think Warzone has to do?
It's hard to say, man. Like, it's a free game. I know they make all their money on those microtransactions. Like, that's how it all started with Fortnite and all that stuff. So, I mean, that's how they make their money. Are they really going to waste money and pay people to monitor the cheating when people are just going to play anyway because it's free? And what uh-huh. are you going to do? You're going to ban these guys and then you just make a new account. So who gives a shit? You're cheating anyway. It's not like you care. So
right.
To me, you'd have to pay a subscription or something, I guess, like to have an account for Activision, a $50 yearly subscription. And then everyone else is going to hate it. But at the end of the day, like, every game is like $80 anyway. You're playing yeah. a free game, so who cares? Whatever. But
yeah, because I don't if you know. Get
that,
you,
that's interesting. Because
if you get your account banned, right?
Well, exactly. So, I mean, if you're going to cheat and then get banned, and then you have to pay $50 every time, well,
yep.
who's going to do it? 50 US. 50
US.
There you go.
American. 50 American. American.
Oh, my life savings in Canadian dollars.
Yeah.
So, and piggybacking off of that, so Chris, what do you think Battlefield needs to do to compete with Warzone? Like, what are some staple things that they need to do to compete with Warzone?
Anti-cheat system right off the yeah. hop.
Right.
Yeah. I don't know. That's an interesting one because Call of Duty always has that slightly more animated game that they always attract those kids to. So
the arcade style.
I think they have to do enough to win the people over that have been frustrated with Battlefield lately. Just
yep.
the same game. That's a really yep. good one. What they can do.
Yeah.
I just think it comes down to a numbers game. You attract enough people away who are sick of Warzone and want brand new. Uh-huh. And you got to find a way to keep them. You got to keep them happy. Warzone, though we kept Verdansk all year, they did a fantastic job with some of the updates, like the Haunting of Verdansk. That went on forever. All the free publicity of all the streamers getting the scare chests.
Right.
And then they posted on their social media sites, attracting the people in, like influencers would on Instagram, or like you advertised yep. for Dixie's photography. It got them the viewership that they needed. Yes, that was me that followed you.
Oh, I seen. And there was someone else too, a Nova Scotian photographer.
Both of them are me.
Oh, both of them are you. Oh,
nice.
Oh, only nice. Got three photos. Oh, fuck. Come on, Chris.
That's fucking
you
know, guys.
You should be with guys. Your camera. You should be with your camera, not playing Warzone.
Mine's a drone. I shoot aerial photography.
Yeah, he's yeah. got a drone.
What? So you should be out with your drone taking pictures.
That's awesome. That's fantastic.
But yeah, no, anti-cheat for sure. I agree. If it doesn't come out with anti-cheat right away, that's going to be suspect. at best, I think.
I 100%. If they don't step up to the plate, because the biggest bitch about Warzone, Warzone's fun. Warzone's amazing, but the biggest bitch is the cheaters. Now, I'm not good enough to be in those lobbies with the cheaters, but I know people that are, and I play with them, and I watch them, and I talk with them. And,
we catch them.
Yeah, we do. I mean, we catch them probably
once in a while.
20% of the time. These guys are catching them 60% of the time. That's unreal.
That's because you don't join on me. I joins on you. If you joined on me, well, we'd be in the great lobbies, the double diamond back fucking lobbies, you know?
Those are the ones that have the hackers. That's the point he's making.
What?
Is the hackers are in those diamond lobbies.
No, but what I'm saying.
Wait. What? I join on you? Man, I'd buy that like I buy a used condom. No way. No way. You're not getting diamonds.
Listen, I would be if I had good internet and didn't live in the Arctic.
Excuses are like assholes. Everyone's got one, son. Come on.
Listen. What I do now, and I'm always pinging at 100, buddy. If I was pinging at 20.
I'm not going to lie. Between you, Stu, and Chris, and me. That's fair. Well, Santana can't even connect like 20% of the time.
Santana, don't you live in TO?
No, I'm an hour north of Toronto.
Okay. So you're a little
where I live. I'm surrounded by.
It's still Toronto light. There should be good
county forest.
There.
Right?
You should still be able to get a Toronto McDonald's Wi-Fi there. You know.
It works for the first three or four games, and then it just bogs out.
Oh my God. Right? That's exactly
If you got that reference, I'm surprised you guys missed that. I was self-deprecation. Anyway.
It works better than yours. Yeah.
No,
I'm waiting for Uncle Eli or Elon Musk there to drop the satellite internet up here. Like,
I'm on a waiting list for that.
Me too.
2022.
Oh, mine's gonna come. Mine's gonna come this year. Mine's gonna come.
Oh, really?
Before the end of this year. Yep.
Yeah, so the only thing I got going is I got gigabit internet.
It's supposed fiber. To be legit. Yeah, it's supposed to be legit up there.
Let me put it this way. So I've been in the north for 3 years.
Okay.
And when I first came to the town I live in, Northwest Tel is our internet provider, cable provider, whatever, right? The only, like, they're gangsters, like, the works of them, they're gangsters, just saying.
Yeah.
So when I first came, it was 300 gigabytes of internet a month for $189.99 Canadian plus tax.
Bohica.
Taxes here.
That's Bohica.
Oh, it's bullshit, right? And then... they came up with a 500 gig package about a year later for the town I live in. And then finally, about just before COVID, just during COVID, the first month, they let everyone have like no overages. Like the overages cost is great. Like 1 month, I went over my 300 gigabytes by like 100 gigs because like Warzone and stuff, downloading the games and shit. I always put my shit in rest mode. So, and I like to stream in 4K. So, I just blow through internet like it's no one's business. And I had like an $800 internet bill. So I wasn't too pleased.
What?
Like, I'm here to make money. Oh, swear to God, man, I would print the stuff up and show you. I don't care who sees it. Like,
I believe
it's,
it.
It's not fair. Here,
all I got to say
is take advantage.
Surf, I got to say is I'm glad I'm America. I'm glad I'm America. You and I, America.
Amen, brother.
I'm not going to make any comments about that. but so they just dropped Unlimited after like 3 or 4 months of COVID when COVID first happened.
Nice.
So, and now that package is like $239 a month Canadian. So plus tax, obviously. Man, so that's what I pay every month just to play with you ugly bastards. Sorry, Chris.
What was that, Chris?
I said Mrs. Steele's chiming into the chat for you there, Steele.
Oh, absolutely. Because because anybody who's ever watched our show, anybody who even understands the show, understands how pissed off he gets at the internet.
Oh, yeah.
He turns bright red. And I'm like, this motherfucker looks like the Jolly Green or the Kool-Aid guy.
I've broken so many things because of my internet.
He's just like my background. 100%.
Oh, 100%.
He looks like a little hothouse tomato when he gets right angry.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Well, I'll tell you what, guys. We are going to get to the Steel Stash and Gorilla's Goods. But, Surf, love it. Thank you so much. Absolutely.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate you guys. I love you guys.
Thanks for coming on.
So much fun. hanging out with you guys.
Yeah, I think this was phenomenal. And I hope you're joining us for our Friday night stream party after this.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that goes for all you guys. If you guys want to play.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much, Santana, Chris, John, Surf. Thank you guys so much for doing this. We really do appreciate it. I thought this was really fun. I think it went really well. I think we'll probably look to do this again, maybe in a couple of weeks for sure. And yeah, if you guys are interested in playing a few when we transition over to the Friday night stream party, definitely hit us up.
Yeah, I guess in 2 weeks' time we'll talk about how Montreal Canadiens are playing for the Stanley
Cup. Oh Lord!
We gonna fight. Don't bring that shit here. Wait till Monday. Listen, he's talking shit Monday.
In the stadium, but woo! Like
I'll put 100 on it. I'll put 100 on the Vegas Knights right now. I'll put 100. 100 right now. You got discretionary income. No, you got discretionary income. 100 right now. 100 right now.
100 Canadian or 100
American? American. American. American.
$100,000.
American.
All right. We really do got to get out of here.
America. Guys. Always a pleasure, everybody.
We appreciate you guys. Thanks so much for showing up.
Take care, guys.
We will discuss this bit later on.
Absolutely.
While we're gaming here.
100%. 100%. We'll talk
later, Bagheera.
See you, Bagheera. Peace. Santana, thank you, girl.
See you, sir. See you, John.
Bye, guys.
Oh, my gosh. How awesome was that?
That was wicked. That was awesome.
That was, I don't think it could have gone any better.
No.
I don't think it could have gone any better.
I don't think so either.
Absolutely. Okay, let's get to it, man. My God, this is the longest show. This is going to turn out to be the longest show we've ever done, including our first one. And so let's go ahead and get to it. Let's get to Steel Stash and Gorilla's Goods. And I'm going to set this up.
Wait.
Anybody who's listening, this is where we jump in and we get a recipe, a drink, a cigar, a wine, and we review it. Steel came up with this great recipe that he's done since he was a kid, and it's phenomenal. I tasted it.
Yeah.
The family killed the potatoes. What's the recipe, brother? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's beer chicken and then with a side of, honey roasted potatoes. And I went ahead and kind of documented documented everything about making it. And we'll just run the videos here and you guys can watch.
What are we doing
so
here?
I'm getting,
so this
basically,
is the rub.
I got... That's the rub. Let me get
the rub.
Let me get the recipe in the chat. Just one sec.
Yeah, get that in there. Okay, so it's paprika. It's smoked paprika. It's cumin. It's cayenne pepper, garlic powder, onion powder. Unbelievably tasty. It might be the best thing I've ever tasted in my life.
It is so good, man. God. And it's so simple, too. Here, I'm going to post. Here's the one sec. Let me bear with me for a second, guys.
Yeah, exactly. Mrs. Steele, who made the rub? But who made the rub?
She right? did. She of did. Course I she came did. Upstairs. I was like, hey, babe, I'm going to make the rub. She's like, I already made it.
It's
I was
done.
Like, oh, okay.
It's done. And
thank
so
you,
and then
you
put this wonderful rub on there, and then you stick a beer
can
but up
first,
the chicken's ass.
There's one thing you got to do before you put the rub on is it says in the recipe olive oil. We have grapeseed oil. So that's what we used, but you got to baste it with oil, so then the rub sticks to it.
You have to. Absolutely.
This is the chicken recipe. I think that's it. And then I will post the potato recipe. We get into the potatoes in a minute.
And it's you stick a beer can up a chicken's ass, and it's absolutely wonderful. And that's what it looks like. And I can't even tell you the smokiness, the cumin, the paprika, the heat from the cayenne.
It's like a rotisserie
phenomenal.
Chicken, but better.
Oh my God, it was unbelievable! And of course, you're drinking because you put the half in there, and you're drinking that shit. I know you.
Oh yeah, of course.
I didn't drink my beer.
I was gonna use it to base, but Mrs. Seal's like, nah.
What's this?
This is a little rig. You can buy this at any like grocery store or a cookware store. It's literally for it's like a platform to put the chicken on. So you can see it's just big enough to fit the beer in it, and then the metal part is actually what sticks to the sides of the chicken when you shove it up there.
Yeah. And it I don't have one. I didn't have one of those. I had to prop it up with some
skewers. Use a pan?
No.
Yeah, there you go.
I had to stick it on the grill, and then I had those metal skewers, and so I hooked them around my thing and stuck them up in there nice and tight.
Yeah, dollar store for the win. There you go. Who am I trying to kid? Mrs. Steele bought that.
Yeah, she knows what's she knows what's going on.
Yeah.
And so anyway, so you grill this, right? You guys, you turn
this goes on the barbecue.
Absolutely.
So you turn the barbecue on. I turned, yeah, so there it is with the rub on it. I had the grill cranked up to high for about, I don't know, 15 minutes, cleaned it all up. And then originally I put it on and still left both burners on, but you'll see as we progress through the cooking that it starts to crisp up a little sooner than I wanted to. So what I ended up doing was turning the grill off on one side and then kept one burner on. So yeah, we're gonna check this thing out. Yeah, I had to take the top rack off because it wouldn't fit. Big bird.
Yeah, I had to do the exact same thing. I mean, I don't have a huge grill, but yeah, I had to take it off. Okay, I'm gonna tell you right now, my family killed the potato. I had one bite, and that's all I got in passing as we were cutting up the video today.
Oh my God!
I got
one
bite, and it was the most. It was just. Just the flavors, and so I did a little different. I did it a little different than you, because you said in your video that you sent me, you said the mustard powder is essential.
Yep.
Okay. I put the Dijon mustard on there and mix it. At first I put the Dijon mustard. I used the real mustard and mixed honey together. And then I basted the potatoes on there. So I didn't use powder.
Oh, that would be good too. Oh, yeah, that would be good too.
I'm going to try the powder one. I did. The only reason why I did that is because I didn't have any powder in the house. I don't understand why I don't have mustard powder. But anyway, I did it with that. Are you shitting me? Are you shitting me with the flavor? The flavor was phenomenal. The taste, it exploded. And you had so much. And then when you couple it with the flavor of the chicken, I win.
Yeah.
It's over, Johnny. It's over.
Oh, dude. I was hoping, I was
look
pretty confident you were going to enjoy this.
Look at that. So look at that bird.
It started to crisp up a little bit too much. So it's only been on there for about 20 minutes or so. So I'm panicking. I'm like, okay, now we're done. Now it's coming off the grill. The potatoes are there. The skin's starting to fall off. Now we got everything all cut up. And we're getting ready to plate that up. And it was unreal. The smoke you get from the barbecue and the rub absorbs into the chicken, especially if you take the time to get it all up in there before you put it on the barbecue, really makes a difference. Oh. And the potatoes are just like melt in your mouth. They're soft. You can see the glaze on them from the honey. Mm-hmm. The onion is a wonderful thing. You don't necessarily need to eat the onions, but the flavor that comes out of the onions is unreal. I mean, obviously I'm eating them.
I'm eating that shit. I straight up ate that shit because nobody in my household likes onions besides me. I said, at least save me that. And the missus said, okay, that's fair. And I'm like, yeah, I didn't get anything else.
Well, I'm glad the family got them out. I'm sure they liked it. And what's crazy about this little sidebar conversation? This actually, Mrs. Steele brought this up because she bought the chicken, and originally it was not intended to be for the show. But I was digging through the freezer, and I was like, "Look at this chicken!" I was like, "I haven't had a beer can chicken in a while. Let's do that." But it was $5 for the chicken. You know how much a pack of chicken breast is? Like 6 chicken breasts where I live cost you about $25. You can get a whole chicken for $5.
Right? Give me the whole chicken because I can
yeah,
butcher some
I'll
shit.
Get, give me 5 of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
And still saving money.
No, 100%. 100%. Yeah. All right. Well, and if anybody, I wish the wife was supposed to bring me out a plate, but my wife is almost 9 months pregnant, and she is at the end of her rope with it. And so she's probably sleeping.
Doubt.
We've had a rough go. We had to go to the hospital. She was really sick. So I'm sure she's, I'm sure she's sleeping, but anyway, let's get to it. Let's get to the sports, baby. I'm so excited about this. So what's going on the East?
Well, we kind of got into it a little bit there on our panel before, we had to give the boys the boot, but what we got going on is we got both semifinals are now figured out. We got Montreal versus the Golden Knights, and we got Tampa Bay going up against the Islanders. And Tampa, as you can see here, Tampa on the just finished dispatching Carolina. Carolina had a great season. They're just not quite there yet. And it's kind of the same old story. Every year they're just almost there, but they just, there's a few pieces. They need goaltending, really is what they need. But yeah, man, the Lightning have been on fire. Braden Point, just an absolute killer in the playoffs. God almighty, the guy only makes $7 million a year, but and he might be the best deal in the NHL. It's unreal what he's been able to do so far.
And what did Tampa do with the salary cap?
So talk there's about a little bit of controversy, whether or not it's real or not. You guys can make your own decisions on this, but Tampa Bay currently is $18 million over the salary cap, and there's some comments that have been made, including Dougie Hamilton, a defenseman on Carolina, said we just got beat by a team who's $18 million over the salary cap. You know, a little salty. Basically, in the NHL, there's a salary cap for the regular season, and then once playoffs start, it doesn't matter. So what Tampa did was they kept one of their best players, Nikita Kucherov, on injured reserve all year, and then when playoffs were about to start back up, they activated him. So he doesn't count against the cap, and people are upset. I don't mind it. It's, you know, it's in the rules. If you don't, you know, like you said, don't hate the player, hate the game.
Change it.
Lots of other teams have circumvented it. If you don't like it, you can vote on your next CBA to get it changed. It's part of their agreement.
No, absolutely. And that's going to be a good series. I really think I'm excited about it. And I'm not a big hockey guy in the context of knowing everything that's going on, but I do know that Tampa Bay is a perennial. We're always there, and I'm really excited.
I mean, they won it last year. Mm-hmm. They kept most of the core for the most part. The Islanders are an interesting team. The Islanders play this like trap, like bore you to death, like just drain you, grind on you, and then pounce when you make a mistake. Yeah. And
reminds me of another team in the playoffs we're going to talk about too.
Yes, and they remind very similar to what the style of hockey the Montreal Canadiens play. They don't have the big stars up front. They don't have the big names on the back end. But what they do is they play a very structured system, and they will hit you and grind you and frustrate you to no end, and they'll get excellent goaltending. And it just seems like you can't win. Yeah. And they'll break you, right? And that's how the Islanders and Habs play.
Absolutely.
And the Habs going up against the Knights, if you look at it purely on paper, it should be a wash for the Knights, maybe five games max. Mm-hmm. But this year's been weird, man. There's been some crazy upsets, and the Habs just have that ability, like I said, to just suck you into playing their style and just make you want to quit.
Yeah, they'll grind it out. And, you know, the thing – well, first off, anybody that wants to play with Double Cross that's in the chat right now or that's watching – he's being very modest. He's pretty fucking good, and Cross is a great teammate. So he's looking for some join him. Trust me, and he is an awesome guy. He's a good player, a better person. So get on that. But back to the game. So the thing is the Avalanche had owned the Knights in the regular season, right? They took care of business, and they went up 2-0 in the series.
People were starting to say the Knights were imposters.
Exactly.
There was some talk being said.
There was some chatter.
Yep.
And then the Knights come down and laid a smackdown on them. The first two games, two or three and four.
Four games straight.
And then all of a sudden they come alive in game five. And they win it in overtime. Mm-hmm. And it was great. And they got Fleury. The cat from St. Louis, I cannot pronounce his name. Who's the cat?
Petrangelo.
Right, he was the series
on
MVP,
the back end,
and he was phenomenal. And then the game six. I mean, game six was 6-3, but it was a lot closer than that score had indicated. And I'm not, so obviously I was overexcited. I'm a huge Knights fan. Cook and Maddie. I don't know if he's watching it, but I mean the Knights are just awesome. They've been around in existence for 4 years, and they've played in the least the conference finals three of the four.
I'm over here in Toronto 17 years since we won a series, and you guys have only, yeah. I've got socks, you know, underwear older than you guys, and you guys have already been to the Stanley Cup Finals once.
Absolutely.
And potentially going again.
Absolutely. And
it,
you know,
breaks my heart.
And the thing with the Canadians, the Habs, I mean, you said it with the Islanders. They are, they'll lull you to sleep. They'll play that boring game. They'll grind you. You know, they're like that big guy, that big man in the middle in basketball, or that football team that has that big O-line like the Titans that just lets Derrick Henry and then
when the fourth quarter comes, you don't want anymore.
Absolutely. And that's what the Canadians are. That's what the Habs are.
Yep.
And you know, and this is Canada's last hope. So I'm hoping that they make it through it in the context of putting a good series. But I obviously want my Knights to win, and I'm going to drop 100 against Dixie anytime you want, bud. American, though.
Let's go. Let's get that signed and sealed, baby.
Absolutely. So let's get to some basketball. We're here.
Yeah, let's do it.
Here's your pick. So if anybody watched our number one show, our first show, still pick the Phoenix Suns, and here they are, baby. Here they are.
I'll give a little caveat. So I'm not the biggest basketball fan by no means, but I make an effort to be informed on everything sports just because I'm a sports guy.
Mm-hmm.
And I've always had a soft spot for the Suns just because of my boy Steve Nash, Victoria, BC guy. Want to go dribble the ball in the backyard?
Oh, yeah.
But, and the Suns, like with what Chris Paul has been doing, man. Unbelievable. Every week we talk about this guy being the leader, and then every week he just gives us more reasons to talk about how he's the leader. And now he's scoring. Look out. Before he wasn't really scoring. Now he's scoring. The guy put up 21 points, 11 assists in game one, and then game two, a modest 17 points and 15 assists, just leading the charge, leading by example, picking the team up, taking them to where they want to be. Unbelievable effort. And he's the best guy on the court in that series.
Oh, by far.
End stop.
And I can't pronounce his name. Is Jokic or Jokic?
Was
the MVP. But right now, Chris Paul is the best player on the court. He is the general. He's leading everybody. Mm-hmm. He's making the right decisions, and he's putting people in the correct places. And it's phenomenal to watch him on the court. And when you made that pick, Steele, I went –
we talked about it, and you were like, you know what? I mean, they're good, but I don't know if they're that good.
Still, you were onto something. You were onto something, and I was overly impressed.
Put money on it. Shit. We should have probably would have got a good price.
Well, yeah, because you know, I'm definitely the cat that's at it. In the context of I'm betting. As you can tell already with Dixie. But no, it was they're. Yeah. What's Maritime at? Basketball. Oh, no, he doesn't.
Hit it.
Let's go. Mrs. Steele with the $5 tip. Thanks.
Absolutely.
Thanks very much. Appreciate that.
Love Mrs. Steele. Mrs. Steele is one of my favorite people I've ever met. But anyway, now we're going to get back into so the next part of this, which I'm really interested in, is my Utah Jazz. So the Utah Jazz are they came out of nowhere. They were expected to be like a 4 or a 5 or a 6 seed. Mm-hmm. And they have came out with a whole new style of basketball that I'm overly impressed with.
Yep.
And they have a chance. They have a huge chance. And they're playing against the Clippers right now. And they're up 2-0.
And they're wrecking them.
Well, you know, here's the scenario. Number one, Donovan Mitchell. Anybody who understands Donovan Mitchell or understands basketball, this cat is absolutely on fire. He dropped a 45-piece in game one. He dropped 37 game two. Where in the hell is Kawhi Leonard? He's not there.
I don't know, man.
He's absent.
I don't know,
man.
Not as advertised.
Absent. Well, of course you don't know where – you've never heard of him, Dixie, because you live in bumfuck Egypt and you don't pay attention. That's your own problem. That's y'all. You brought that shit on yourself. Anyway.
He should know who Kawhi is. He won the Raptors the friggin' championship. Right. Come on,
yeah,
John.
There you
Let's go.
Absolutely. But, no, the point is Kawhi went absent game one. Yeah. Mediocre in game two. And Donovan Mitchell is everything as advertised. He did it last year. I think he averaged 35.6 points in the playoff series last year. And he's there again this year. And so I really think the Jazz are going to come out of the West. And I really am excited to see it. They play tomorrow.
Let's go, Dixie, with the tier one sub. Let's get it.
Absolutely. So I'm big on Donovan Mitchell. I'm big on the Utah Jazz. And the other series that we need to talk about real quick are the Milwaukee Bucks and the Brooklyn Nets. Unbelievable what Brooklyn is. Brooklyn has, and they're without James Harden. He got hurt in the first game.
Yeah, right? It's tough. But even without Harden, I don't know if Milwaukee's got it in him to come back.
No, absolutely. And the thing is how do you compete with Kevin Durant? Kyrie Irving may not be a leader. He's a little mentally different, but man, he can play the game. Uncle Drew.
Yeah.
Right? I don't know if you remember him, Uncle Drew, from the Pepsi commercials. But man, guys, I don't know how you competed with them. They went up 2-0. Milwaukee came back. Giannis, I can't pronounce his last name, and nor will I try. Right, I'm not going to give that an effort at all.
Yeah,
but they came.
And Middleton stepped up big.
My God! And that's what Middleton stepped up huge last game.
Yeah, dropped 35 right? on him.
And they have to. Yeah, he has to have one or two, and Middleton has to do it. But that's an interesting series to watch. And so I'm going to be on that now.
I really think it's going to take more than them. I think it's going to take someone coming off the bench or one of the lesser known guys that are going to have to step up every night if they want to compete against Brooklyn.
Oh, 100%. And they got it. They got it because Brooklyn's got too much
Johnny
firepower.
With the biddies.
The tickle biddies. They got the tickle biddies.
Let's go.
Oh, you know what? You know, hey, anybody who's watching. So Steele and I, we want to give some stuff for the bits. And we want to have like some nice, you know, nice sayings and some things that you can do. Guess what we're gonna put on for the bits? There's this country song, and a matter of fact, as you're talking about it, I'm gonna find it out and I'm gonna surprise you with it. Anyway, they have to have a stepped up. But now let's get to your neck of the woods. Let's get to the party.
That's good shit, buddy. GG's.
UFC 263. I'm gonna turn this over to you because I'm gonna find this because I want to play for everybody. But this is an awesome card.
Yeah, this is a really good card. And Izzy's going to – I don't know, man. Izzy looked absolutely terrible at 205. I know it's a different weight class. I know it's different, but he just didn't look good.
Yeah.
And Marvin has looked absolutely phenomenal. He's coming off of wins against Jack Hermanson. He beat up the loudmouth Kevin Holland, who had absolutely rocked everybody prior to that. I am putting my money on Marvin Vettori. He's a 3-1 dog, pays really well. And then I'm also going with the dog, not as much of a dog as Marvin is, but Brandon Moreno against Figueiredo. Okay. The big thing with Figueiredo has been his power, and nobody can withstand his power at flyweight. But Brandon fought him already for five rounds and felt some of the biggest shots that he could possibly throw. And he didn't go down. He never even looked phased. And he stunned Figueiredo multiple times. And maybe if he doesn't get kneed in the nads, maybe he's able to actually finish that fight. It was damn close. It was one of the best fights I've ever seen. It was up for fight of the year. It came second to Wei Li and Joanna Jacek. But
I'm excited.
Yeah, and then the third fight is the pride of Stockton himself, Nate motherfucking Diaz, coming out of the coffin to fight Leon Edwards.
He's walking brain damage. Okay.
Yeah.
He shouldn't be doing it. I'm going to be honest. You shouldn't. I do know enough about that. Cat should not be doing it. He's going to be drinking through a fucking straw the rest of his life if he keeps this up.
Yeah, he lit up a joint at the press conference.
That's fair.
And people were like, okay. But anyway, yeah. So Leon Edwards, his last fight against Belial Muhammad, who's also fighting on this card, he got DQ'd after one round for an eye, a really nasty eye poke. It was a very dominant first round. He was beating the wheels off of Belial. And, you know, if I'm a betting man, which I am, I think Belial probably would have finished him in a couple rounds.
Yeah.
Leon is going to absolutely – there will be brain cells on the canvas coming out of Nate's ears. I think he's going to pound the living shit out of him. I am hammering him on a KO, TKO, and finish. If you want you can just take him winning, but I think it's a pretty safe bet that he's going to finish him, whether it's a KO, TKO, submission, the doctor stoppage, whatever. It's going over, to see five rounds.
No, it's over. And
I've got one fight on the prelims to watch. This is one of my favorite guys, Drew Dober. He's basically a Justin Gaethje 2.0. Trains with Justin, and he's an absolute animal at boxing. And he's coming off a kind of disappointing loss to Ilya Makhachev, basically a Khabib 2.0 at a different weight class. Yeah. And I think Drew's going to rebound and box the shit out of this Brad Riddell kid. I don't even know who he is. I don't care. I think Dober's going to beat the wheels off of him. And I can't wait, man. Tomorrow's going to be so fun.
I'm excited. Yeah. I'm excited. And it's going to be phenomenal. Check it out. We're going to have a recap next week. So here this show. Oh my God, man. I can't believe we pulled this off. But
yeah,
this is going to be we're going to get through the ads. Here we go. One, two, three, four. Drop them out. Let me see them titties. Going to take a long look at those tig old bitties. Areola's looking nice. Nipples looking real pretty. Come on, let me get her at your boots.
Are you playing something?
Yeah, can you not hear? Let me see
them knockers. No. Take a long look at those big hand poppers. Just squeeze them together. Oh, there it is. Yeah. Come
on,
let me
get her. Hold on. Can you hear it now? Here we go. This is it. This is our bitty song. Drop them out, let me see them titties. Gonna take a long look at those tig old bitties. Areola's looking nice, nipples looking real pretty. Come on, let me get her.
I love it. Knockers gonna take a long look at those big hand poppers. Just like a jaw dropping baby. Come on, let me get her. Oh shit, I love it. That's awesome.
Well, I'll tell you what, that is going to be our show, and that was phenomenal. Big thanks to Surfer. Thanks for coming on, Santana, Chris, Dixie. Thank you. I don't know if that could have went any better with those guys and gals. I mean, right? And it just a great time. Steel, you did a phenomenal job. I am so excited about that show.
It was great. And thanks again on behalf of both of us to everybody who showed up to hang out, chime in the comment section. It really means a lot. We have a blast doing this, but this show is for the community. It's for the people. You know, we're average gamers, great guys, and you know, everyone here that we're great people, and we do it. We do it for you guys. We love hanging out. It's a blast, and I can't wait to get to the stream party.
Absolutely. If you guys, anybody that's watching, if you want to stick around, we are going to get started on our Friday night stream party. And I'll tell you what it is. It's a lot of smoking weed. It's a lot of drinking some alcoholic beverages. And it's some decent, mediocre gameplay, let's be honest. But we might get a win or two. But we are going to have some fun. And we're going to play some music. And we're going to get this party started right. So I'm going to do this. I have to go use the restroom because I've been sitting here for 2 hours and 13 minutes and 57 seconds. And I've been holding it.
I'm going to sign off really quick for our podcast listeners and our archived listeners. Thanks for listening. If you guys enjoy listening on the podcast and you want to get involved, come check us out on Twitch. We like to have fun in the chat. You get to see all of our videos when we break them down. It's just a bigger, better experience. But I mean, we love that you're listening to the podcast. Keep it up. If you got any suggestions on what you want to hear in the pod, shoot us an email at steelandgorillagaming@gmail.com. And yeah, that's we're going to sign off. We're going to switch over to the Friday night stream party. Thanks, everybody, for listening. Peace.
Peace.